Bye.
Hi guys, it's Pure Gamer, and right now we are doing GTA 5 Online Gunrunning DLC Episode 3. That's a big sentence, that. Here we go. Right, so obviously I've done a bit of messing around on the gun range with a couple of friends. Got a couple of people. 6 o'clock tonight. It is now 25 past 2. So it's 6 o'clock tonight. I'm going to be doing a live stream and a recording. Both going on Twitch, Beam, and YouTube. There will be a mayhem because we're going to be selling all the stock here right now. Yeah, that stock that we had yesterday is still not full. We're going to go and give you a little tour because this is also streaming on Twitch as well as being recorded on my Elgato and going to go on YouTube. But this is going to be interesting. Well, let's see how much we can sell this for, because this is the same. If you go back, I'll put links in the description. It's also in a playlist called Grand Theft Auto Online Gunrunning DLC. Also, the latest playlist of making money for gunrunning is in a playlist. So if you want to go and watch how to make money, then definitely message me on Twitter or go in the comments. And if you can't find my playlist, I will put it in the link for you guys, and I'll, you know, help you get to that. But right now, we are rolling in cash. We'll do a quick little tour so I can show you how much stock we actually have. Let's go to the buggies, everyone's favorite part. You're probably wondering why I have no cash, because yesterday I had 300,000. Well, I kind of got to 555,000, and I was like, I wanted to customize my command center. Yeah, you're probably thinking, hang on, you customized it the first time round to fully customize how you wanted to buy it. Then you customize it again to make the massive garage, and now I customized it back so I have the small garage so I can put my own personal cars in here. That I think is better purely because just look at what I've put in the back. Look at that. And I can put whatever I want in the back, Monero, anything. And the interior is black and red. It's like a black interior with red trim around it. Looks really nice. Let's go in here. See? Looks amazing. Yeah, hi Jeff. Look at that beast. Fully tuned out and everything. Right, so let's get straight into giving you a little tour of how much stock we've got and how much area we've actually got to fill. Right, okay, let's get on the buggy. Do. Look at all this beautiful stock. Just look at it. There's massive amounts of stock here. Oh, let's go and have a look at some stuff. Why not? You're probably thinking, oh, I'll get straight to it, but why not? We've got to wait for it anyway. They're like shotguns, them assault shotgun things. They've stripped down an AK-47, they've made it into a shotgun. That's pretty cool. Ammunition. So look at these, what are these? They seem to be AK-47s, I think. Yeah, they look like them anyway. All the more of them, I think, actually, the assault shotguns or whatever we're going to call them. Little look over here, the same guns, there's some bullets there. Oh, nice missile. I wonder whether the actual final cut, when it, you know, when that blue bar of stock is fully up, I wonder whether that's $1 million or more, and you can sell it for like 2-3 million. Because if we can, that's going to be brilliant ways of making money. Just spend a day and a half, you know, building the stock up, and then leave it, and then come back on it, and just mess around. You'll have no problem whatsoever making cash. There's definitely something behind there. There is a few areas that I have noticed that do seem to be areas where they're probably going to open up in future updates. Well, let's hope anyway, because these bunkers are massive, but wouldn't it be cool if they just made them even bigger? Because we like updates, but we like getting even more stuff added in to update and update. It's pretty cool. But what I would like is, you know, you've obviously noticed that I'm wearing this army outfit. I've been wearing it for, I think, one or two of the videos now. I think I might have literally just changed it before I started this video. Again, back to this costume. But wouldn't it be cool if they added proper military clothing? Like Merryweather clothing, where you have the gun holster and the proper body armor. Because what I'll show you a little bit later on is when you go into the gun store, there is actually a proper body armor outfit. But when you put it on, it's the gray silver one. So it's not actually that realistic. But there is some outfits in the game, as you know, that have proper body armor and things like that would be cool getting. And could you imagine wearing Merryweather or proper military clothing? That would be awesome. Now, I know Rockstar are never going to see this, but if any of you do want to help out and just share this to Rockstar, then do so. But let's see what we can do. Steal supplies. Confirm. See, we're not even wasting any cash stealing supplies. We're just spending time while we wait for more supplies to be actually built. Right.
When I hear arms are moving around the state at the behest of hostile governments, it upsets me, okay? You're going to get in a buggy, bring down these shipments and collect cargo. And I'm going to make some tea.
Okay then. Oh, there's a mounted gun on the front of it. Yay. Right, okay, let's go. Oh, a bit too late now, isn't it? Ah, getting quick. Let's go. Right, we need to buy one more sticky bomb, maybe. Come on, sticky bomb. Come on. There you go, that's the one. For some reason, this van one that we always seem to do that's close to the base, well, bunker, always seems to be the one that pretty much goes past the bunker road. So I always stay and wait for the two to go past the bunker, and it's always one of them two. Sometimes, if you time it right, it's always the one that goes straight past as you get out onto that road. But if you're too fast, then you have to wait for the second one. Right, okay, whoa. There we go. See, that's quick mission, and we've just stocked up the bunker. Doesn't take long. It's amazing.
Alright then, that'll keep him busy on the floor.
Right, okay, let's go get some more stock. Let's go. I like this outfit. It reminds me of what sort of like you see in the films that the army, like the American army were when they're off duty. Don't know why. Just does. Don't know why. I think it's the cap and the torso part. We get the security upgrade. We get a security camera here and we can check the whole area. But it's like 300 grand. So is there any point? Yeah. You do get the, like on the crate one, you do get people that will come and attack your supplies. So what I might do when I get a sensible investment, I might just Basically, I need to keep an eye on the crates because I can't let any of the crates loose. But I know the only time that the people come and attack is when your crates are fully stocked up, as far as I'm aware. But no one's been attacked yet. So okay, there might not even be an attack feature. Because I know that the grow house, the cocaine lockup, and the meth lab, no one ever attacked them. But you could still buy security and all the upgrades. And that's the only thing I haven't bought in the bunker, is the upgrades for security. Because I haven't seen anyone being able to attack it. I don't think online players can attack, but the random NPC attackers can, I think. I don't know. We'll just have to find out as we go along. Right, off we go. Okay, maybe not that way. That's a metal bollard. There we go. Flying high. Like an eagle. There's an airport there. If we get into a helicopter, that'd be brilliant. Don't even know why I've got this car out. I'm not sure. I haven't a clue, actually. Right. What the hell? Right, so this car, it's okay. Brilliant light. One of the fast... I think it's the fastest sports car on full tracks that have loads of corners and different type of terrains. Purely because it's got the best acceleration, definitely. It's also got the best handling. But when you've smashed at the front of it like that, as you can see, it starts to turn. So I just left it straight. If it was smashed up a bit more, it'd be turning this way or turning that way. But luckily enough for us, we haven't smashed it enough. What have we got? This'll do. Frogger. Right. We're only going across the Alamo Sea, I think. Hopefully. Because the missions aren't that far. Right, off we go. Right, okay, we're above the area. God knows what's going on here. Okay, we're getting shot at. That's what's going on. They're firing flares at me. Whoa, 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 whoa. Chill out, people. Whoa. Okay, now we haven't got an escape vehicle to get back quick, but oh well. Oh no, they're not these ones. They're the people that eat you. The cannibals. Up in that mountain thing, that mountain village. They're them people from there. You can tell because they got the axe. The tomahawk, that's it. It's basically a tomahawk. You stop firing flares at me. You only set me on fire. I know you want to cook me. And pretty much eat me, but you don't need to roast cook me yet. Right, let's see what vehicles they have. Okay, well, guess we're taking this vehicle. That's a massive bright light. I think it's because it's shiny, yeah. They're definitely brighter than usual. I don't know, they feel like they're brighter than usual. That's basic, and they feel like they're really bright. Okay. Well, that sorts the problem of lights out, doesn't it? We're back to normal. There is no light. Problem solved. Here come the attackers, probably. Oh, we're upside down. Okay, here comes the fun. Okay then. This is going to be interesting. Whoa. Don't know why that happened, but okay. Get up. And you're dead. I'll pick that crate up. Let's get back in the rat loader. And off we go. Oh. Skills. Maybe not skills. Come on. Let's get over the bridge. Quick, quick, quick. Ah! Thought I was going into the water there. Worst scenario that could possibly happen. Get stranded with no vehicle besides it in the water. Hate these roads. I like them for like dirt rally cars and like proper off-roaders or a really fast car that's got enough acceleration to not do that badly. But when you're in a car that's not really brilliant at anything, it's just literally clicked in my head. How are all of that stuff on there staying still on it? Like when we're doing rolls and doing things like that, shouldn't it all be coming flying off? It's just wood and a couple of barrels. Unless you use Gorilla glue and Gorilla tape. God knows how that's working. But oh well. Off we go. Okay, so this happened. Yeah, well, the scenario that we didn't want to happen, happened. Brilliant. Right, okay. Yeah, let's get to the side of this water. Right, let's call the Nero and get that as an active car so we can keep calling that instead of the stupid allergy.
You need something, huh? When you arrive?
Yeah, I do.
Let me know. On the way.
Yeah, it better be. You're dead. Come on, put your head up. And you're dead. Thank you. And I'll take me Nero. Come on. Get in the car. And off we go. I don't know why I always do that. You probably noticed that I always press X to make sure I have the hand. Have no guns on me for some reason. I don't know why. Just a habit. I used to do it in GTA 4 all the time. So guys, let's get straight in to getting some more supplies. Let's just do a quick check of what we can sell. Yeah, I think we could probably sell this for $1 million soon. It's going to be a very victorious sell. We're going to make a lot of cash. And there's not going to be a problem with making any cash. Like they said, the best money is arms. And we are making money with arms. Well, firearms, not just arms. Not like arms off people. We're not ripping arms off people and selling them. We're using firearms. But yeah. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. And out we go. I like this. You have like a little driveway. You can have security guards there in there. If you're doing like a role play with this. It'd be pretty cool that. So it's 6 o'clock tonight, so it's now 3:09, so it's 6 o'clock tonight. We are going to be having a massive stream and recording of me selling my stock. No one I have seen on YouTube yet has sold any stock, so I'm not really sure, and I don't know whether anyone on YouTube has done a full warehouse stock, and I don't know whether we're going to have a full warehouse by then, but if we don't, we don't. If we do, brilliant, even better. We'll know the actual final cut of how much a full warehouse is. So it's going to be very big streaming recording. And if you want to come and watch, I'll put the link to my Twitch channel in the description. Also, the link to my Beam account, aka whatever Beam's changed to now, it's changed its name. I'll put the link to that. And also, obviously, you'll have my YouTube channel that you'll be able to tune in if I live stream on YouTube. But what I might do is I might cut up the raw video, basically the live stream, and put it into a video. Or I'll upload it as the part 2 live streaming. Because this is part 3 of the Gunrunning DLC. But the live stream is only on part 1. We need to do a part 2 live stream. So I might do that as a live stream, guys. So we can just have one massive video. But this is all helping to make cash for Gunrunning. Because it's part of Gunrunning. And you're going to be able to buy things. So probably the best thing to do, if you have a small amount of money, because Espley, I was surprised yesterday, he has $36 million, but he went for the cheapest bunker, no gun range, no armory, you know, he didn't go for anything expensive, he's not bought any APCs or anything that I would expect him to buy, he's only bought the bunker and the command center, and that is it. He seems to be not buying anything, none of the gun upgrades, because it's all too expensive, as he says. I think he'll buy some stuff later on today, maybe. But as he was saying, there is no point buying the most expensive stuff. But if you do buy the most expensive bunker, you are in the center of the heart of the game, the very middle between Blaine County, Sandy Shores, and hang on, we got some attackers here, and in the middle of the city. It's in between all that, so you're safe with missions. No worrying about the time and getting to them and things like that if you're in a slow vehicle. But yeah, this could be interesting now, because I can see a tank, and I know I've done a few tank missions, but I never completed them purely because they always blow up for some reason. Just before I literally just outside my bunker, they always blow up because we've like run over too many cops or blew up too many cars near us and things like that. I do like this gun. It's like an M14 or M16. I'm going to find the official real name of what the gun it is meant to be made on. And find the official name of this. Because it reminds me of what Tom Clancy used to use. But this is basically the normal or legit pistol. And that is the special. That's just the normal carbine rifle. Right, you ready? Someone's behind it. And boom. But imagine if we could get this outfit there. Ignore like the gas mask, but the helmet and the kit and the body armor and the gun holster. That would be awesome. Or the Merryweather costume with the gun holsters. I'll show you some stuff that we could possibly get in a future video. Alright, here we go. Right. Okay, whoa. Sorry about that, guys. As you always know, I do try to aim to take notifications off, but I've not messed around with that in a while because it's just purely getting videos out for you guys to watch. But I will do that actually straight after this video. But then, no, the minute I turn it off, people will be inviting me and messaging me, and I won't get them, and it's going to be hard. So I'll probably do it just before the stream tonight. I'm recording tonight. Getting shot at from some far distance there. Imagine if the tank was amphibious. Now, I've done the APC tank mission, and I will admit, the APC tank is pretty cool. It's like a little stealth attacker, because them little islands where you do that heist where you get the guy that's like in police protection. Yeah, we were around them islands on the mission with an APC tank, and it was just like a proper stealth mission. You literally sneak up on the water, it's dark. And the next minute, boom, you're on the land attacking, and they're straight back into the water. It's brilliant. Hopefully, we've got more chance now. It's like Fast and Furious 6 when they're on the motorway, and you know, they have that bit, and like Dom's on the other side, and Letty's on top of the tank, and then he does like that, and the tank goes over. And Brian's like, oh, I got a tank on me. That's probably one of the best bits of the film. They got a tank. We need another plan. Whoa. Keep away. We want to try and complete this mission. And you. Kind of sneak under the car and blow yourself up. Okay. Yep. Come on. Work with me now. Help. Keep away from me. I shall survive. I've just realized we're on the wrong highway. We need to be on that one, but it's okay. We'll cut across the roads in a bit. Hopefully we'll make it. Let's hope anyway. Well, we could go up there. Let's see what this tank is capable of. I doubt it'll be able to get up here because it's not exactly fast, and that's what you need on this game for an off-roader to go up mountains. It needs to be fast. Or just go diagonally like this, like in every game. It's like a game hack, that, isn't it? Like a life hack, pretty much, on games. If you want to get up a hill, just go up diagonally. You slowly make your way up. Slowly rolling up the hill. Come on, final push up the mountain. Okay, that's going to be a problem. Yeah, I thought so. Okay, we're coming straight back down this mountain. I can say, oh no, maybe not. Maybe not. Turn. Yay. Right, okay, go back. There we go. Go between here. Pretty much just evade all police until we can get up here. And back on to, I want to get up on that bit then too, because I can also go over. We'll just see what happens. Because we're not that far, actually. Oh, we're making it up. We're nearly up. And we're up. Right, let's go up this one. In fact, no, there's no point. Let's just get straight on the road again. On the road again. Thought that bush was a tank then. Don't know why. You need to have a little chat. Well, why don't you chat with one of my massive bullets that aren't seem to hitting you because I'm a bad shot with a tank. Merry Christmas. Okay, we messed this up badly. Okay, we get to meet this guy again. Nope. Goodbye. Au revoir. Anyone else want to mess with my tank? Anyone else? No? Thought not. Okay, this is the closest we've ever got to the bunker without this thing blowing up. So let's see if we can make it now. The last few seconds. And I've just seen that gunner. And I always think when I see this gunner, imagine what they could have done if you had that gunner and you're allowed in it. Basically just go around destroying absolutely everything. Because yeah, this tank, it's okay. But it's not brilliant, this tank, purely because that gunner, and you'd basically do more if you had a gunner too. I think, because it'd be even more fun. They have proper, like, warfares and everything. But here we go. Seems like we've delivered the tank. Oh, no. This is a cool cutscene. Right, okay. 462,000. Supplies are full. Let's have a little bit of a mess around on the gun range, I think. That's what's in order right now. Just to wait for a supply to go down. Even though supplies, you can keep supplying up. Right, okay, here we are, the gun range. Let's do some testing. I think it's more fun when you have a couple of people, because you don't have to beat a target, you just have to beat each other pretty much. Right. Carbine rifle. One, go. Okay, come on. Guys, let's all pray that I get this. Come on. I've not hit these exactly on target. Wouldn't it be cool if it was more just like a free session thing where you could just literally go up to them, open it, start it, and shoot any of the targets you wanted. And you got the points thing, and it just tells you how many points you get. There was no, like, failed or not failed. Yeah, we failed that, but it's just a mess around for me. I don't take it serious anymore. I did on that first video, guys, I showed you. With the actual, like, gun range. It's more just a mess around. Right, okay. What we'll do. So I've got an assault rifle. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Okay, I got a bit closer. That's alright. Right. Failed comes on in big writing now. Right, let's do combat MG because we've not done this yet. This isn't customized though. The only problem is with this. It takes well too long to reload. So close. So close. We nearly did that. I think if I got a few more exactly on target, we'd be brilliant. So let's try that again. Go away, failed. We didn't fail that inside. Inside, we nearly did that. Okay. Yeah, that was bad. That was really bad. Okay, let's see if the stock's gone up, because I want to see something. Whether you use the gun range and then stock goes up, I wonder. Yeah, a little bit. Just, I guess it just goes up every couple of minutes. Right, okay guys, that's been it for this video. We are next video going to be doing a little bit more supply stock, and then the next video after that will be the 6 o'clock live stream and recording on the Elgato, and that will be selling supplies. So if you want to tune into that, guys, it's 6 o'clock. The link will be in the description for this video and the next video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more. Press the notification button down below for instant notifications, and I'll see you guys next time.